Hello everyone, welcome to sqadia.com. I'm Dr. Hina Khan and today we're going to discuss a condition which is known as proptosis. So you define this condition to be the forward protrusion of the eyeball that is noted down in the individuals, and there are multiple causative factors towards the development of this proptotic conditions in the patients. As a clinician, you should know the differential diagnosis when you get to have a patient of proptosis or the forward protrusion is noted down in the eyeball of these patients. So you should know how to define this condition and you should know the differential diagnosis towards the development of this condition. We'll be overviewing the condition and along with that, we'd be classifying the different categories of this condition. There can be the tumors as one of the causative factors towards the development of this proptotic conditions in the patients. One of the most notorious condition, that is the thyrotoxicosis, is discussed over here in this lecture, and we'd be giving the differences, how can we differentiate a patient who is suffering from thyrotoxicosis and presenting in the outpatient department with exophthalmos. And on the other hand, the other etiological factors would also be discussed in this lecture. Along with that, we have the different tumors, we have the different traumatic conditions, and as well as we have the congenital conditions also presenting to you with the proptotic conditions in the patient. Clinical evaluation has its own step-by-step methodology that would be discussed over here, involving the inspection. We have palpation, percussion, and auscultation techniques. And these are coupled up along with the radiographic imaging techniques involving the CT scans, MRIs that are coupled up along with the clinical evaluation of the patient. And obviously, we'd be considering the laboratory investigations over here. Getting the baseline of the patient is very important over here. The thyroid hormone profile is the mainstay when you have a patient of exophthalmos or you have a patient of proptosis. Then you'll be ruling out any of the systemic illnesses along with this laboratory investigations, as well as any of the parasitic infections have to be ruled out along with this proptosis or patients of exophthalmos. The imaging techniques would involve the CT scans, MRIs, that are basically the non-invasive techniques of imaging, and then we have the invasive techniques involving the cavernous sinus thrombosis and the AV fistulas. If you can grab your hands on some sort of a mass, you can send that for the histopathological findings and perform the tumor markers on these masses. And obviously, the treatment guidelines would also be noted down in these individuals. So you should know how to manage these patients. You can perform or you can give these patients with some sort of steroids, radiotherapies, and obviously the supportive treatment is the mainstay when we are having the patients of proptosis. On the other hand, we should know basically there is a condition which is known as enophthalmos, in which there is an inward protrusion of the eyeball, and there are these multiple causes towards the development of this enophthalmotic conditions that would be discussed over here in this lecture. So we have a range of ophthalmopathies being discussed on our website, so do watch these lectures. Thank you for watching sqadia.com and get access to watch the complete lecture.